Lord, I want to simply say thank you. Thank you for the sun, the sky, the trees, the flowers, and the birds. Thank you for the sense of smell, the sense of hearing, sight, taste, and touch. Thank you, Lord, because not only can we all agree that we could not have gotten these things on our own, but right now in this chamber, we have another opportunity to be even more connected, and that is through our work as legislators. Lord, as we stand before you today in this chamber, we all know that we had to make choices. We had to choose to become public figures. We chose to give countless speeches, knock on countless doors, and in some case, limitless dollars to get people to send us to this great historic place where decisions are made that impact the lives of millions. We chose this. We fought for this moment right here. We fought to be the voice for so many people and legislate in a way that they can believe in government. However, in this moment, coming into this budget season, I have concerns. I have concerns about how we're going to keep our why in focus. Lord, there are a lot of people, including some of us right here in this chamber, who are struggling. There are plenty of problems, attitudes, anxieties, uncertainties, fears, and heartbreaking issues happening right here, right now. However, when we invite you to these situations, we can turn these concerns into calmness. You can change those problems, anxieties, attitudes, uncertainties, fears, and heartbreaking issues into a level of peace that surpasses all understanding. You are the I am, and I believe in you. So please help us keep focus and the people in mind. Once again, those of us who are not here to serve others and keep humanity in mind while sitting in these historic, revered seats that we all fought to sit in, simply remove us. The time for seat warmers while people are suffering are over. Make us uncomfortable and wake the people up. We should be a government that people can depend on. Remind us that we are not above humanity. Amen.